What if I told you that the Republic was now under the control of the Dark Lord of the Sith?
No, that's not possible.
Count Dooku is one of the most fascinating characters in all of Star Wars. Introduced as a political idealist, Count Dooku has always felt remarkably different from every other Sith we've encountered in the franchise, with a calm and cool demeanor that stands starkly against the menacing and melodramatic cruelty of other Sith. Today, I want to ask, was Dooku even really a Sith at all? I was recently trying to get through The Light of the Jedi, the New High Republic book, when I got bored and decided to reread Dooku Jedi Lost again. When I did, I noticed that there is a lot that seems to suggest there is more to Dooku than it may initially appear, and I wanted to share with you these findings today about the hidden goals of Count Dooku.
I've been looking forward to this.
Before we get into that though, today's sponsor is the self-proclaimed MMORPG mobile game, Raid Shadow Legends! You may already know that Raid Shadow Legends has more champions than you can feasibly play in a lifetime and has been around long enough to have more updates than would be needed to fix Cyberpunk 2077. You may also know that their latest update, the Doom Tower, is so massive that you will certainly be unable to uncover all its hidden secrets. But did you know that Kathleen Kennedy does not play Raid Shadow Legends? You don't want to be like Kathleen Kennedy. My friend also doesn't play Raid Shadow Legends, and he recently bought a Forces Female t-shirt. You don't want to wear a Forces Female t-shirt. Raid Shadow Legends won't make you wear one. My brother also doesn't play Raid Shadow Legends. My brother is colorblind. I am told that if he played Raid Shadow Legends, there's a chance he may stop being colorblind due to the awesomeness of the graphical fidelity. I am not a science person, so I have no idea if this is true. Raid Shadow Legends. Now, you could download the game and grind it out the hard way, or clicking a link in the description like the one in mine will give you a free champion, the Bulwark, as well as 50 gems, an XP booster, and some energy refills, and even an ancient shard as soon as you get in the game. So click the link in the description if you want to help out the channel and you don't want to end up like Kathleen Kennedy.
Warning, Raid Shadow Legends does not have the power to prevent you from becoming Kathleen Kennedy, nor is it able to stop you from buying a Force Female t-shirt since it's just a free download mobile app. Raid Shadow Legends is unrelated to the scientific impossibility of becoming a dead fly regarding what we did not do. There is no scientific evidence to suggest that Raid Shadow Legends has or even can cure colorblindness or any other ailments. Side effects may include more time spent on your phone and microtransactions that go to pay YouTubers like me so we can afford more Saber giveaways. Player discretion is advised.
Raid Shadow Legends.
Well, one might say he was always a bit out of step with the decisions of the council. Much like your old master. Qui-Gon Jinn?
Really?
Oh yes, they were very individual thinkers. Idealists.
Now to talk about Dooku as a Sith, I think first it's important to establish who he was as a Jedi. His whole life was dedicated to the protection of the oppressed and the destruction of the Sith. When Dooku was participating in the Padawan Selection Tournament, he fought and practiced hard to gain the attention of Leen Kastana, the Jedi Master that he respected the most. Dooku was paired against his best friend, Sifo Dyas, and ordered to duel against him for the demonstration. Dooku was incredibly conflicted. He wanted to impress Leen Kastana, but he didn't want to humiliate his best friend. Between the two of them, there was no doubt who the best duelist was.
Says the guy who aced lightsaber class for,
the last 10 years. Yeah.
Yes, Dooku has been renowned as an expert duelist since the age of 6 years old, and he only ever continued to improve. During the duel, Dooku remained on the defensive, allowing Sifo to press for an advantage. Of course, even blindfolded as they were, because they decided that the two should be blindfolded for their test, Dooku blocked every single one of Sifo's attacks, and eventually disarmed him. Despite his desire to prove himself and the fact that he was ordered not to let his attachments impede the duel, Dooku was moved by compassion and used the Force to return Sifo's blade back to him, allowing the two to finish the duel together. Dooku fought with great skill and honor, which is why he felt such rejection when his hero, Leen Kastana, selected Sifo Dyas as her Padawan, and not Dooku. While the other Padawans were selected because their masters were impressed by them, or they liked them, or wanted to spend time with them and train them, Dooku was not. Dooku was selected as a project. Yoda chose him because he was worried about Dooku and his desire to destroy the Sith, and he thought that it was a waste of time, and so he wanted to personally ensure that Dooku stopped with this foolishness. Dooku desperately wanted the approval of his master, yet the two found themselves at odds more often than not. Dooku knew that if he accepted the status quo and stopped challenging the Jedi, then Yoda would be proud of him. But he wanted Yoda to see what was wrong with the galaxy. He never stopped craving the praise of his betters, and especially Master Yoda. He wanted to prove to his master that he was strong and a capable leader, and that he had taken the Jedi teachings to heart. Dooku's desire for power all traces back to his fear of abandonment. Dooku was abandoned as a child when his father found out that he was Force sensitive. He called the Jedi as soon as he found out and left his son outside alone in a basket for the Jedi Order to find him. His father didn't love him, left him alone in the cold. His own master didn't approve of him. Dooku was just a project to Yoda, and the master that he did want chose someone else. Dooku wanted to prove to all of them that he was worth something. Even with his need for approval, Dooku was too idealistic to be a yes man. Time and time again, Dooku was brought face to face with injustice, and he pleaded with the Jedi to let him do something. But each time he did, the Council said no. Each time he asked, Yoda would give him a lecture trying to find some platitude to throw Dooku's way. But to Dooku, it was always the same. The Senate wouldn't approve, so we can't. This planet is behind on their taxes, so we can't save them from pirates. Those people are ruled by an oppressive tyrant, but he's a member of the Republic, so we can't intervene. Adding to this, by the time Dooku was a Jedi Master, his friend Sifo Dyas began experiencing visions of the Sith's return and the end of the Jedi Order.
But not the Jedi. They do not torture.
Are you sure?
Leen Kastana hid this from the Jedi, telling Dooku that the Jedi had built a special prison specifically for Jedi who saw the future.
And his visions? Leen.
They're getting worse.
You should talk to the Council.
What good would that do? They'd lock him away.
He's not a criminal.
No, but in their eyes, he's dangerous. I've heard...
What?
They've opened a new correctional unit on Lola Seyu. For those with foresight.
Within the Citadel? I find that hard to believe.
You haven't been there.
This reinforced Dooku's need to prepare for a Sith uprising, as well as his distrust for the Jedi Council. Kastana warned him that if Sifo returned to the temple, Yoda would certainly sense his power and lock him away. The audiobook never states whether or not Kastana is being overly paranoid, but Yoda spends the entire book talking about the dangers of the future, certainly lending credence to her fears.
If we could just examine the prophecies.
Unknowable the future is. Only to the dark side prophecy leads.
When Dooku was a Jedi Master, he received a message from his sister on Sereno, who said that the planet was in great distress. However, the leader of that planet, who was a tyrant, had declared himself independent of the Republic, so the Senate would not authorize Jedi intervention, even though the oppressive tyrant was causing the death and destruction of his people, people who were Republic citizens only a few years ago. This greatly angered Dooku, and he defied the Jedi's orders and went to intervene in this conflict himself, eventually killing the tyrant, his brother, the current Count of Sereno. After this, Dooku took his brother's place and took his birthright as the new Count of Sereno, leader of the planet. And it was upon doing this that he left the Jedi Order in order to dedicate himself fully to restoring this planet and creating a place where light and peace could truly flourish, away from the bureaucracy and corruption of the Republic and the complacency and apostasy of the Jedi Order.
You are wrong, Master Yoda.
Leaving the Order, you are.
I have no choice.
And what of your duty to the Republic?
The Republic is changing, Yoda. Has changed. We all know it, even if we won't admit it. A moment ago, Master Kastana told me that the Senate would happily send what is needed to process our new resources. I have no doubt that is true. And yet the very same Senate refused to help when my sister begged them to stand against the Abyssin. The Jedi refused to help.
His goals as Count of Sereno was to use the position to reform the Republic. He wanted to make the galaxy a better place by using true Jedi ideals to rule Sereno in wisdom and benevolence. He saw his role as a sort of philosopher king, not a tyrant or a oppressive ruler, but someone who ruled based on morals, integrity, and idealism. And you know what? He was actually successful for a long time. For about 9 years, Dooku did everything in his power as Count of Sereno to reform the Republic. Even though this freed him from the apostasy of the Jedi Order, unfortunately, it left him without accountability, leaving him as a prime candidate for Palpatine to seduce to the dark side. However, Palpatine was unable to sway Dooku using traditional Sith promises. Dooku was not interested in compromising his morals for the sake of power or even approval. He didn't want to rule the galaxy, he just wanted the galaxy to be better. And he also didn't want to destroy the Jedi, he wanted them to be reformed. But Palpatine was cunning, and he was able to determine all of this before beginning his campaign to win the Jedi Count to his side. So, that's exactly what Palpatine promised Dooku, a chance to reshape the Republic, doing away with the bureaucracy and the corruption that the Count saw as the greatest threat to the light. But you see, even then, Dooku still wasn't a real Sith. He didn't want power or control, he only wanted to rule because he truly believed that no one else was capable of doing so without being impeded by corruption. And he may have been right. He joined Palpatine because he thought this was the best way to reshape the galaxy. He wanted to start a new Jedi Order after the Clone Wars was over, a Jedi Order that did what was right, not what was politically advantageous. Dooku never relished in violence or let rage motivate heartless killing sprees. Now, many will look at his story and say that Dooku was a good man lured to evil, but I'm not sure that's totally true, at least not completely. Yes, Dooku did commit evil acts, but he only did so when he believed that they were absolutely necessary. Remember this scene from Attack of the Clones? Dooku tells Obi-Wan exactly who the Sith Lord is.
What if I told you that the Republic was now under the control of the Dark Lord of the Sith?
No, that's not possible.
Hundreds of senators are now under the influence of a Sith Lord called Darth Sidious.
Something that no one is willing to admit until the next movie, which is 3 years later. He tells Obi-Wan the whole story, but Obi-Wan doesn't want to believe him. As the audience, we can be tempted to write this off, since this isn't the first time we've seen a Sith make this sort of promise or offer, but Dooku is different. When Anakin asks Padme and later Luke to join him, his offer is to rule the galaxy side by side. Sure, he wants to kill Palpatine too, but he wants to stay a Sith. Dooku doesn't. Furthermore, when Palpatine offers to Luke and Rey to come and sit by his side or take his place, again, the assumption is that the Sith will still rule, but Dooku says specifically he wants to destroy the Sith. See, I don't think Dooku is lying here. I think he really was ready to take Obi-Wan with him to work both sides of the war to kill Palpatine and reform the Jedi Order. Dooku cared deeply for his Padawan Qui-Gon, Obi-Wan's master, and he hoped that Qui-Gon would have trained Obi-Wan to be like-minded.
Qui-Gon always spoke very highly of you.
I think that he really did want to destroy Palpatine and make a new Jedi Order with Obi-Wan at his side. Dooku wants to destroy the Sith. His entire life has been dedicated to that goal, and he sees himself as a double agent. He is not truly Darth Tyrannus, but he believes that by taking on the title of Darth Tyrannus, he can get in close with Palpatine so that he can use Palpatine to accomplish his goals of resetting the Republic government and then killing him to start his own Jedi Order. Don't believe me? Do you ever notice the fact that Dooku is the only Sith to never have Sith eyes? Not even for a moment. The only time we ever see Dooku with Sith eyes is in a vision experienced by Yoda in the Clone Wars, and it's not even real, it's an illusion created by the priestesses. Dooku never has Sith eyes. Practically speaking, this is because Dooku never relishes in dark side acts. He commits them, but he steels himself, he doesn't let himself feel the negative emotions associated with the dark side. They were necessities, unpleasant as though they may be. A small evil for the greater good. Dooku didn't enjoy it, he didn't feed into it. He steeled himself and did what needed to be done and then moved on. Dooku joined Palpatine because he believed that Sidious' plans would lead him to his ultimate goal, a benevolent galaxy led by a reformed Jedi Order. Dooku was not a conqueror or an oppressor. He was a reformer, a political idealist, if you will. You see, yes, Dooku was given the title of Darth, but I would argue that he never truly turned to the dark side. Not fully, anyway. I'm sure there's an argument to be made that you can be a Sith without being of the dark side, and so you can make that argument in the comments if you wish, but I think the important thing here is that Dooku saw this Sithly title as a means to an end. He didn't embrace the Sith heritage, he merely saw this as a tool in order to reshape the galaxy and rebirth the Jedi Order. His goal was ultimately and always to redeem the Jedi. But those are just my thoughts. I want to know what you, my friends, have to say about our favorite galaxy far, far away. So leave your thoughts down in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Or if you learned absolutely nothing new, you can feel free to leave a thumbs down completely guilt-free. Because that tells me I'm not doing my job. Thank you all so much for watching. And as always, may the lore be with you. Now and forever.